from the Spongiform Encephalopathy Advisory Committee.
In 1996, the government announced that BSE had jumped to humans.
The unit has identified a previously unrecognized and consistent disease pattern.
It was 12 years after the first case at Pitson Farm, 10 years after scientists first discovered the possible risks in that confidential memo, and 6 years after Agriculture Minister John Gummer assured the public that beef was safe to eat. Lord Phillips' inquiry into BSE concluded that the government's campaign of reassurance was a mistake. He suggested that involving Cordelia was the wrong option, but he didn't criticise Mr Gummer's handling of the crisis. It's now been 4 months since Andrew's death, and Christine is on her way to see Mr Gummer. She thinks he could have done more.
We're about 2 minutes from John Gummer's office. We've just passed the Houses of Parliament, and it's because the government and the establishment didn't put precautions in place, the appropriate precautions in place, that I'm now actually having to confront Mr Gummer about my son's death. There's a lot of emotions going through here at the moment. I'm shaking like a leaf. I'm really scared that I'm actually going to let Andrew down and become angry, and I don't want to become angry. I want to be measured, and I want to actually put him on the spot. When you said beef was safe, why did you say beef was safe when it clearly wasn't?
Because I believed it was. I was prepared to eat it myself. I was prepared for my family to eat it because I believed it to be safe and because all the evidence showed that it was.
I have spoken to several scientists. There was selective research. They were sat on.
No scientist of any kind was stopped by me from either giving their information or, in many cases, being cross-examined by me. I only wanted to know the facts. Look, how could I possibly have allowed my family and myself to eat something that I thought wasn't safe?
I have actually got recommendations from the Phillips report. It is now clear that this campaign of reassurance was a mistake.
Well, I can only quote Lord Phillips, who specifically said to me in the report, in his statement about the report, that he had no criticism of me.
You were Minister of Math. What about ministerial responsibility?
That's what Lord Phillips was saying about my ministerial responsibility. He had no criticism of me.
How can I accept that when Lord Phillips says the possibility of risk to humans was not communicated to the public?
I do not believe I could or should have done other than I did do, and I also believe that that is exactly the answer which the independent inquiry came to. So it's not only my belief, but it's the belief of the independent inquiry. And it's also my memory, because I remember that at every point and on every occasion, I sought to make the best choice, the best decision I could for the safety and health of myself, my family, my country.
This is not a disease without blame. This is not a disease that just happens. But it's the British establishment against me, and I don't know whether I'm able to even make a dent in it, but I'm going to try on Andrew's behalf. He asked me to do this. When he was dying, he said to me, "Mum, this must never happen again. Mum, you must find out who did this to me, and Mum, you must expose them."
Scientists estimate that 1 in 1,000 people in Britain could be carrying the infection, but they still don't know how many will go on to develop vCJD. Christine has published all her research on a website. She's determined to keep searching for answers, and she wants to hear from anybody who might be able to help her find the truth.
I will persist with my investigations and I will continue my research, and every day, every week that I come up with some more stuff, it will go on the website.
and I will pursue these men and women that I consider responsible. So this is not the end, it is the beginning, until I have justice for Andrew and all the other Andrews that are to come.
And if you'd like to know more about Christine's story, then the details are on our website at bbc.co.uk/insideout. Well, I'm afraid that's it for this series, but we'll be back in the autumn. So if you've got a